But for me, I'm like, you know what? I'm still an individual. Mm-hmm. I'm not like everybody else. So why would we all check off the same boxes? So I just do Mormonism my way.
You know, a lot of the first episode and probably a lot of the series centers around Mormon and right. Mormonism and, you know, what that is and kind of what that means. And you consider yourself Mormon 2.0. So what exactly is that?
Okay, so Mormon 2.0 is meaning, what I mean by it is I'm not checking off all the boxes and I don't really fit in that square. So I think, you know, when you think about the Mormon church, there's like a laundry list of things don't ever do, which basically makes you perfect. And I am far from perfect. So we just found Mormon religion in general is a choice. So we choose to be LDS. I love it. I feel like I have a much better life because my family chose to convert in New York when the missionaries knocked on our door. But right. For me, I'm like, you know what? I'm still an individual. Mm-hmm. I'm not like everybody else. So why would we all check off the same boxes? So I just do Mormonism my way.
Yeah, I think that's great. Was the Mormon community upset about the show being shot?
No, oh my gosh, no, they love it. No,
really?
I think the opposite. I think everyone in Utah wants to be on the show. I think it's the exact opposite.
Yeah, so I would take that you haven't lost any Mormon friends since announcing that you were on the show then.
No, and I think some people might start coming back to church again when they figure out they can be Mormon 2.0. Why not?
Totally. I mean, then what are some of the biggest misconceptions about the Mormon church? Because I feel like a lot of people aren't that educated about it.
There's a lot of misconceptions. One, people don't understand the church name is the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. So yep. Right there, they don't realize it's a Christian church. I have to say, I heard my son playing Fortnite and his friend's like, are you a Christian? He's like, no, I'm a Mormon. And I'm like, Henry, you're Christian. Because I thought that was bad. And I'm like, no, it's kind of funny. So I think that's one misconception that people don't realize it's the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. So, you know, there's a strong love of Jesus and a strong love of God. And then I think there's other things like, hey, you have to have, no one drinks in Utah. Like so many of our friends, we are with a friend on Sunday night that was, she's a recruiter for like big CEO jobs. And she said, you know, people are like, whenever she asked them questions, they're like, wait, if I move to Utah, do they have alcohol there? Yes, we have lots of alcohol here.
Now, following the season, are you still on good terms with everybody? Are you still talking with everyone?
I'm fine with everyone. Like I'm easy, but you know, I have favorites for sure.
Can you tell us who those favorites are?
I love Meredith. Like I will always be friends with Meredith. And I find Jen Shaw hilarious. I love her energy. I'm a high energy person. And like, I think with Jen, she is just so funny. I love Jen Shaw.
I do too. I think she's fabulous. Do you really think that she spends $50,000 a month?
100%. Yeah, 100%. I mean, it's not hard. You can add up her outfits real quick.
That is very true.
Shoes. Something in the middle and then the bag, easy. That's easy.
Like
two or three outfits.
That's so funny. I mean, going back to Heather a little bit, it does seem like even in the trailer that you two really do butt heads this season. Would you say that the two of you are really kind of at it throughout the entire show?
I don't go for anybody. If you choose to go for me, that's on you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't need to go for anybody.
Yeah.
If you wanna come for me, go for it.
Mm-hmm. We'll have to wait and see. I think, you know, as a viewer, I think a lot of people are going to be shocked about Mary's story, about how she, you know, revealed that she is married to her step grandfather. I mean, hearing that the first time, I mean, were you surprised by that?
I mean, I would not be human if I weren't surprised by it. Like I was definitely taken aback. Like, wait, what? Mm-hmm. Like, I was shocked. I remember when I first heard it and I know my reaction. I'm like, no way, no way. My dad has a stepsister, and you know, when our grandparents married each other, I honestly, my grandfather was married to two women before, and then died with a boyfriend before he passed away. And like the second wife, you know, when I was, you know, when I met my new cousin, instantly like, ew. It doesn't matter how cute he is, ew. So I was a little like, wow, okay. But you know what? I don't know Mary's story. I've never walked in Mary's shoes. Mary does have fabulous shoes. So if anyone, if I were going to walk in, it would be Mary's.
Mm-hmm.
But not in that way. And I think that that's Mary's story to tell. And you know, it's interesting. I mean, religion, culture, it plays a lot into our choices. Yeah. And I think it plays a lot into Mary's. And I think she's, you know, she's the only person that can tell her story. But yeah, it was interesting. I think it was definitely, whoa, shock effect. Yeah.